Hello everyone, this is your lovely good old neighbor Nicky can frozen into a no time to die pain to when you and welcome to another amazing video. Last time I talked about my top 10 most anticipated movie of 2023, and now it's time to talk about these top 10 my least anticipated movie in 2023. These are the movie I am not looking forward to it. I am not excited, and I will never waste my movie money for this piece of garbage. But I don't have any Dishonored to mention, so let's get started and get this crap over with, because I don't want to talk about this video. So let's get to it, shall we? Alright guys, coming in number 10, which is Ned and the Flash. I cannot believe why this film is trying to be like Spider-Man No Way Home. DC, stop being like the MCU. Honestly, that's copycat. Anyway guys, I am not excited about this movie. After I heard of the production problem about this movie, about the racing of the Snyderverse, I'm not excited about this movie. Because honestly guys, I cannot wait till teaser trailer came out. Because if the teaser trailer came out on February, I cannot wait to do a Nettle trailer roundup. So speaking of the trailer roundup, stay tuned for my tonight video called my trailer whammed up episode, because I've been lacking some trailer wins this week, so I was so busy in life, so I hope you guys understand that. Anyway guys, this movie don't need to be like No Way Home with all, because honestly, you are not getting a kind of dollars in the box office for No Way Home, and you're not getting that kind of money, you never will be. And this film it's gonna be terrible. But honestly, I'm kind of excited, because I always forgot Supergirl. At least Supergirl is way better than that Supergirl movie. Came out in the 80s. Yeah, I'm not talking about that. Anyway, guys, Adrian Miller, get yourself together. I don't want to hear you. Honestly, I don't want to hear you. You're hating a chill on a woman and in the sneaking people's house who got some drugs. Honestly, you don't do that. You are the Flash, not a drug dealer, man. And sorry, guys, and that's why the Flash is in my number 10. Screw this movie. Big time. Alright guys, coming to number 9, which is Ned and Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. Honestly, I used to be excited about this movie, so after I heard the news that Warner Brothers is going to keep Amber... Amber Heard in this movie, and I was like, oh, you got to be kidding me. Honestly, Amber Heard, you do not deserve to be in the DCU. I do not care what Zack Snyder said. Yeah, Zack Snyder would be ashamed of himself casting Amber Heard as Meredith. Honestly, Amber Heard, she is honestly one of the worst actress in Hollywood, and for God's sake, she's even worse than Kim Kardashian, Megan Thee Stallion, Melissa Coffey, and last night we used Jennifer Lawrence. Yeah, I like Jennifer Lawrence, but after I heard her about her shenanigan, what she doing right now, yeah, I lost respect to her, and she is honestly one of my top 5 worst actress I ever seen. And for God's sake, she was just like Amber Heard. Honestly, I'm not excited about this movie because of Amber Heard. No, I do not like the title. Like, The Lost Kingdom? Are you kidding me? I do not like that title. How about you call it Aquaman, The Return of the Kingdom? That's much better than The Lost Kingdom. Honestly, I'm probably this film is going to be the last Jason Momoa movie, which I don't need no more Jason Momoa Aquaman. Just let it be. Just let it quit. Just let it die, okay? Okay, good. I cannot wait, because honestly, I'm not going to waste my money to see this worthless piece of garbage. So let's see the teaser coming out. So let's see if the teaser will change my mind. But now, I'm putting a movie in number 9. Now let's get to number 8. And I'll probably, you guys haven't heard about the sequel. It came out in 2018, which I haven't seen it. But I'm not going to watch it anyway. Maybe tonight or maybe maybe next year. Alright, coming to number 8, which is Netherland. Alright guys, coming to number 8 is The Meg 2. Who asked for the sequel called The Meg? Well, everyone raise your hand. Everyone raise your hand who asked for the sequel for The Meg. No? Well, this is hands down one of the most unnecessary sequel of 2023. Honestly, I am not excited about this movie. Who in the right mind will see a sequel from the 2018 movie, which I haven't seen the 2018 of the May, because honestly, I might check the film. Honestly, I might check the first film out and see if we see how bad it is, because trust me, it is pretty bad. After I saw the trailer, I was not watching it. So sorry guys, maybe at the end of the year, maybe I can watch the May for the first time. So I cannot wait to tear that thing apart to give it 1 out of 10 or 0 out of 10. Well, even 0 out of 10 don't make no sense. But I'm probably 0 out of 10 is the only good the only thing that I'm gonna give the make. So you guys, and that's why the make 2 of the trends is in my number 8. So yeah, I'm not excited about this movie. So yeah. So you guys, now let's get to the number 7. And honestly guys, even I am a fan of a horror movie, but this next spot, I'm not excited. Now let's talk about it. Alright guys, coming to number 7. It has to be the... Instoto, the Dark Ramadan. I am not excited about this movie. The Lost Key is a terrible movie. I watched it. It was awful. And I am not excited for the next Incendies. Yeah, I am not looking for it. Coming to number 7, it's had to be Incendies, the Dark Ramadan. Yeah, I am not hyped for this film. Because honestly, even I am a horror movie fanboy. Which honestly, I am not excited about this movie. Hey, it's not because of the horror girl. Hey, just because I have horror girl, it doesn't mean it's bad. No, why do we need a sequel for this film? Because the last film from January back in 2018, from The Lost Key, did not do well, and a lot of people hated it. And now, are you telling me you're going to make a sequel for this one? Yeah, screw this one. Anyway, guys, and that's why Extended of the Dark Ramblin' is in my number 7. Yeah, screw this movie and screw this franchise big time, but this franchise needs to die already. That's all I got said. Alright guys, coming in number 6, which is Nerdin, the movie from the sequel who made the first film of the Conjuring universe. It's had to be The Nun 2. Who asked for the sequel for The Nun 2? Okay, first we got The Meg 2, and now we got this. Anyway, I am not excited for The Nun 2. Who's that? I'm pointing my butt. Alright, back what I'm saying. Sorry guys. I am not excited for The Nun 2. I am not hyped for this film because even I'm a fan of a horror element, but honestly, this is hands down one of the most unnecessary sequels from the horror genre, and I am not watching this film. But anyway, I had to watch it anyway because it's for my movie credit, but I need to watch for the first film, and then I will do a rant of this film on Halloween Movie Week, so stay tuned. Anyway, guys, now let's get to the top 5. These top 5 movies and make me angry the most every single time I think about it. Because my number 5, my least anticipated movie of 2022, which is Nerdin. Oh god, who asked for the live action animated, just like Tom and Jerry in the movie, but with Karugi and Mao. Alright guys, coming to number 5 is Karui Vivai. Oh my goodness, I am not excited about this film. After I heard they're going to make a live-action animated movie about the character based on a Rooting Tune, yeah, I'm not excited. Honestly, I would have preferred the animated one. Honestly, I cannot believe why of John Cena is going to voice of Karui. Yeah, honestly... Oh boy, I'm probably pressing is going to be triggered right now. But honestly, I do not care because this film is going to be unnecessary. So I cannot wait to see how bad it is. And I cannot wait to see how god-awful this piece of crap is. Anyway, guys, now let's get to the top 4. These top 4 is even worse. Now let's get to the number 4, which is Nerdin. Alright, guys, coming to number 4, it has to be The Mummies. Who is that? Sorry about that. It's just the door is making noises. Stop it. Making a video. Anyway, guys, coming to number 4, it has to be The Mummies. I don't want to see another crappy animated movie. Warner Brothers just make great animated film for once, because only you did a really good job for the Lego movie, the Lego Batman movie, the Lego movie 2, which is the underrated gem, and now you're making movies like Scoob, Spaceship A New Legacy, Super Pet, and now we got The Mummies. Honestly, I am not watching this piece of crap, and there was no one in the heck they're going to force me watching this. Anyway, I'm not excited about this film, so stay tuned for my while I won't watch this film, because this film is looked unnecessary, cliche, generic. Even the animation is not that bad, but honestly, I think this film is going to be the worst one about a movie of 2023. Now let's get to the number 3. Alright, coming in number 3, and I am sorry, Muddy Puff fanboy, to trigger you right now. I am very sorry. I really want to be on your side, but I really can't, because if I like this movie, I will be a crazy person. It has to be Paw Patrol, the Mighty Movies. I am very sorry, Muddy Puff fanboy. I am not excited about Paw Patrol, the movie 2. This movie looked unnecessary, looked absolutely nonsense, and honestly, I did not like the first film, because honestly, I used to like the first film back in 2021, and call it like a 9 out of 10, and call it like an 8 out of 10, and call it a zero naked awesomeness, which honestly, more look back at that movie, honestly, it did not age well. Honestly, I definitely agreed with Frozen, Rambo I Shot Back, Harry Thomas, and maybe Sean PBS, I don't know, because he don't watch baby movie like he used to. Anyway, I'm not excited about this film. This film is trying to be like the Avengers and Justice League, which honestly, you're not the Avengers, you're not Justice League, and you're not the MCU. Paw Patrol, stop being like the MCU. Anyway, guys, I'm not excited about this film, and this is easily one of my least anticipated Nickelodeon movie ever made. Now, let's get to the number 2, and holy crap, Disney, it's time for Triggered. My number 2. Which is not a what was that? You know what? Let's get to number 2 before I stop like a goofball. Let's get to number 2. Alright, guys. Coming to number 2. It has to be The Little Mermaid 2023. I can see why AMC... I can see why the AMC theater will not show a teaser trailer of The Little Mermaid, but if they do that in the future, I will walk out that door until the trailer is over. This is how bad this movie worked. Who in a right mind want to see a Little Mermaid as a black woman? The Little Mermaid supposed to be white, supposed to be charming, but this film is not one of them. And Disney, stop making your original movie as a live action remake. It's not funny. It's disgusting. It's terrible. Don't you ever do that again. If you're doing it again, I will attack you. And I will force you to watch the worst Disney movie I ever watched. And honestly, I know I'm taking this way too seriously, which honestly, a lot of people, even the Phantom Menace, or boycotting this movie already. But this film really deserves it. Because anyway, even I am not a fan of Jumi and YM, because that's the only content they ever did. But honestly, this film deserves a boycott. Mickey Mouse, you better be ashamed of yourself. Nobody wants to see a Hilly Billy as Ariel. But honestly, I rather have Zendaya as a better Ariel. Because honestly, even she's black, because at least she makes sense, at least she can sing, and at least her hair look redder, and she would be a puppet area. But ain't wrong, Mickey Mouse just boycotted her, and now he wanna get the young girl to voice of Ariel's. I'm not excited about this film. Screw this film, and screw who deduced this film. Screw this. Anyway, guys, and I always really hope this is the number 1, but this one the number 2. But the number 1, my least anticipated movie of 2023, is based on the worst DreamWorks movie I ever seen in my life and waste of my entire life, period. Number 1, my least anticipated movie of 2023, which is not a din. Really, DreamWorks? You had to got to be kidding me. Who in the right mind want to see a third movie, one of the worst franchises ever, and now, all of a sudden, you want to make this abomination? Anyway, guys, my number one, my least anticipated movie of 2023 is Sesame Trust Pupunia, which honestly, that is absolutely a whip-off. Honestly, that title alone, that title is a whip-off to Zootopia. Oh my goodness. And now, Inside Out Fantastic Fantastic One is going to love this video. I do it better than God on November 17, 2023. Honestly, guys, this is going to be the new worst DreamWorks movie I have ever seen in my life. No pun intended. This movie is going to be the worst. Honestly, I was really worried that this film was going to beat Doom Part 2, which honestly, I really hope Doom Part 2 will beat this movie a bomb. And honestly, I really hope this movie bombed the box office, man, because honestly, guys, even I am not the type of person like wishing movie to bomb, which honestly, this is a one of them. Honestly, this movie had nothing to do with this franchise, and please, stop making, honestly, DreamWorks. Stop making your troll movie just like the Lord of the Ring and Jane Bond style. Honestly, troll, you're not Lord of the Ring, you're not Jane Bond, you're not Frozen movie, and you're definitely not Avatars. Stop being like Avatars. Honestly, this film looked absolutely unnecessary. This is going to be the worst animated movie I ever seen in my life. And this is hands down going to be the worst DreamWorks movie I ever seen in my life, and for God's sake, this movie worked even worse than Troll World Tour, and the first Troll movie came out in 2016. Because anyway, honestly, even I am not a fan of 2016 Troll, at least that the first film, at least that movie feels something for anger. But this film did not feel anything. Which honestly, I cannot wait to see the teaser, and I can boycott this big time to make Inside Out Fantastic One Troll good. And I don't care, because honestly, guys, this is what he get. This is what he get. He gave me middle fingers back in 2022. And that's what he get drawing some disturbing picture of Frozen get killed off by dogs. Which, honestly, that's completely heartless, and you know that. Anyway, guys, that's why Troll 3 is the number one, my least anticipated movie of 2023. And Poppy, screw you! Alright guys, that was my top 10 least anticipated movie of 2023. And honestly, you can tell me what your list for your top 10 your least anticipated movie of 2023. Honestly guys, if I see a list that people are not looking forward to Indiana Jones 5, which honestly, I would be cool with it. Which honestly, even I'm looking forward to Indiana Jones 5, which honestly, I did not like the title. Why Dare of a Destiny? Are you kidding me right now? Just like I said in my top 10 most anticipated movie of 2023. Honestly guys, who could mean the Spider-Man Exes of the Spider-Verse would be a way better anime movie than Troll 3? Honestly, who in the right mind want to ask for Troll 3? Actually, for Troll 3, it's kind of reminding me you asked for a sequel for Artemis Fowl and actually for a sequel to Cinema 2021. And Sony, you better not make a sequel to the worst movie I ever seen in my life. You better not do that again. And sorry guys, if you like the video of me talking about these terrible movies going to come out next year, screw the freaking troll movie, and also screw the Little Mermaid 2023. That's all I guess said. Anyway guys, if you like this video of me on me boring kind this troll 3 already, please, I recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification, and share with your whole family. Well guys, 2022 have come to an end. And on January 1st, stay tuned for my channel update. Stay tuned for the big changes on my YouTube channel. It's going to be the biggest YouTube I ever seen. So, hey guys, I'll see you next time. It's all one can picture too. Have a great morning, everyone. Stay tuned for my nether episode of Trevor Whammed Up. I'm very sorry I'm pretty right because I was so busy for Christmas. So, honestly, that video was originally going to release on Christmas, but I was so busy on Christmas Day. So, I really hope you understand that. And I'll see you guys next time and have a great morning. See you guys next time.